you're happy with your panel layout. To wrap up our design, it's time to modify some system configurations. Let's go ahead and click on the Continue to System Configuration button in the top right. First of all, we see a snapshot of our design in the top right with project stats below. You'll also notice that the financial figures have not yet been populated, and that's because we're missing the price. In the center, we have our production estimate charts. And just below that, we have a basic pricing. We can input the total out-of-pocket price for the customer here. And once we save that, the financial figures will automatically update to give us the discounted payback period, return on investment, net present value, and the internal rate of return. And while we're here, let's check our STC price behind this settings button. At the point of this recording, the spot price for STCs are about $35 or $36. So let's change that and save it. Scrolling down a little, we find our inverter settings. And just like our panel library in the previous video, let's go ahead and search for the brand, the series, and the wattage of our inverter. In this case, we're installing a 7 kilowatt Furnace SIMO unit. The next section here is our load profile settings. Here, we can manually adjust what we think the customer's self-consumption rate is by editing this 40% value. Or, alternatively, we can use the simulated load profile. Let's go ahead and enable that. And once enabled, you'll be able to see basic inputs to help us simulate their load profile. And Jane has a family of four. And we can see that the system has calculated a new self-consumption percentage. Looking at the graph below, we can see three different lines. The gray is the customer's load, the yellow is solar production, and the green line is our export back into the grid. Clicking on the settings, we can limit their grid export as necessary. So let's put in 5 kilowatts for this example. We should also adjust Jane's bill. Currently, she's paying about $500 per quarter, and her utility is offering her a feed-in tariff of 12 cents per kilowatt hour. As we are modifying our system, you might have noticed that the financial figures are constantly updating themselves to reflect the changes that we have made. And they look pretty good. So the very last thing to do is to give our proposal an expiry date. Now we're ready to check our proposal. Let's click on the View Web Proposal button, and it will appear in a new browser tab. In this video, we put the final touches on our solar system by setting up some system configurations. And that wraps up our three-part series on how to create a solar system in Pylon Observer. We went from searching for an address, to placing some panels, then finally generating a solar proposal that's ready for the customer.